How to check the motor coupler. Let's say that you put the washer on a wash cycle and turn it on. The washer starts filling to the selected level. When the washer reaches the selected level, it starts to make a grinding noise like this. Turn the washer off. Disconnect the washer from the wall outlet. Open the controls panel. Click on this link if you don't know how to remove the cabinet. If you know how, continue watching this video. Disconnect the wires from the door switch. Use a jumper wire to bypass the door switch to be able to run the washer without the cabinet. Click on this link if you don't know how to bypass the door switch. If you know how, continue watching this video. Remove the cabinet. Connect the washer to the wall outlet. With a timer on the beginning of a wash cycle, pull the knob to turn the washer on. If the washer makes the noise but is not agitating, turn the washer off. And set the timer on a spin cycle and turn it on. The washer starts draining okay, but is making grinding noises. Let it drain the water from the tub. Push the knob to turn it off for a few seconds. Then pull the knob to turn it on. If the washer makes the noise but it won't spin, the problem could be a broken motor coupler, or a bad gear case, or transmission. You will need to remove the pump and the motor to check and see if the motor coupler is broken, or if the gear case or transmission is bad. Tie the drum and the back panel together like this, with a piece of rope or wire. Move the washer forward, and put a 5-gallon plastic bucket like this behind the washer. Lay down the washer on the bucket like this, to make it easier to remove the pump and the motor. Now you could check the motor coupler, and the gear case, or transmission. You need to remove the metal straps that holds the pump in place. Grab the pump, remove it, and tie it to the washer frame. Out of the way, like this. Disconnect the wire harness from the motor. Remove these two screws. Remove the motor holding metal strap on the bottom. Hold the motor and remove the top motor holding metal strap. And remove the motor. As you can see, this part of the motor coupler is broken. Use a screwdriver to remove the broken piece, like this. This is how the original plastic pieces of the motor coupler looked when they first make them. Then they replace them with a new design that looked like this. And then, they redesign it by putting a metal piece on the middle that looks like this, to make them last longer. Set the new motor coupler piece on the transmission or gear case shaft. Use an extension bar with a socket wrench and hammer to tap on the piece until it's flush with the shaft. Put the rubber round piece in place. In this position, I will be using a bench vise to hold the motor in place. If you don't have a bench vise, have someone hold the motor with the shaft touching the floor while you replace the motor coupler piece. Remove the coupler piece on the motor shaft, even if it is not broken. Save it, if it is not broken. You could use it temporarily until you get a new motor coupler kit, if one of the new pieces breaks in the future. Put the new one on the motor shaft. Use a socket wrench like this one and a hammer to set the new piece in place. Put the socket wrench on the center of the coupler and tap it with a hammer until it's flush with the motor shaft. Like this. Remove any grommet left on the mounting plate and put it on the motor. All four grommets should be on the motor before mounting it. The motor is ready to be installed in the washer. Make sure the holes in this piece are aligned like this, and the plastic piece on the motor like this. Put the lower motor holding strap in place. And put the top motor holding strap in place. Make a hook like this from a piece of coat hanger to hold the top motor holding strap in place. Hook the strap with the wire like this. Place the motor on the mounting plate. Make sure the motor seats properly on the mounting plate. Remove the coat hanger wire. And snap the top motor holding strap in place. Be careful you don't pinch your fingers with the strap. Snap the lower strap in place. Secure the straps with the two screws. Connect the wire harness to the motor. Making sure it is pushed in all the way. Turn the motor shaft and put it like this. With the flats on the top and on the bottom. Use one of the pump holding clips to turn the impeller in the same manner as the motor shaft. This will make it easier to insert the motor shaft into the pump impeller. Insert the two pump holding clips into the motor, like this. Place the pump on the motor shaft. Make sure it's seated properly. And secure it with the holding clips. Be careful you don't pinch your fingers with the clips. Stand the washer up. Remove the rope or wire holding the tub and back panel. And install the cabinet. Remove the jumper from the door switch wires. And connect the wires to the door switch. Lower the controls panel and secure it in place. That was the way to replace the motor coupler in any direct drive washer made by Whirlpool. Click on these links to visit my website and to subscribe to my channel.